Hi everyone, it's Melanie from Living Luxuriously for Less, and today I am so excited to be sharing with you my tips, tricks, and ideas on how you can have the wedding of your dreams for $1,000 or less. So stay tuned. Tip would to be to make your ceremony your focal point, and by doing so, it creates such an atmosphere of love and peace and all those wonderful things that you really want your wedding day to be like. Now, I have this gorgeous backdrop here to add to that focal point, and I will link a video down below on how you can do a backdrop for $100. My next tip would be to ask the tables and to get creative with your seating. By asking the guest tables, you alleviate all the costs associated with centerpieces and things of that nature, and you save really big by getting creative with your seating. My next tip would be to have beautiful florals. I think that every wedding needs beautiful florals. And so here are some bouquets that I did for this particular wedding. You can use faux flowers, you can use real flowers, you can use paper flowers. You can just get really creative, but you want to make sure that your florals are beautiful, and you can definitely add to that by adding a little bit of bling as well. Now, my next tip would be to serve cake and frappe. And so by serving cake and frappe, first of all, you're alleviating the enormous costs associated with feeding your guest. And, you know, also, you know, the key to this is to have your wedding at a time that people have already eaten. For example, you want to have your wedding around 2 o'clock in the afternoon or 3 o'clock, because typically people don't expect to be served a full meal at this particular point in time because they've already eaten lunch and they, you know, are not quite ready to eat dinner. You want to make sure that your ceremony is concluded by dinner time. So definitely use that as a tip as well. My next tip is probably one of the most important tips of all, and that is to hire a good photographer. Let me tell you guys, a good photographer can make an average wedding look amazing or make an amazing wedding look average. And so one of the keys to getting a good photographer is you want to get some, maybe look on, you know, like Facebook Marketplace, or look on some other avenues to see if there are any photographers who are looking to expand their portfolio, or even hire a second shooter to a photographer that you absolutely love. That's one of the things that I did for my wedding. I could not afford, or it was not in my budget, to hire the photographer that I love, but I could afford their second shooter. And a lot of times their second shooters are just as good as they are. So that is an amazing saving tip. The next one is that you can save on sound. And so at Lux Studio, I have along that wall where you see the galvanized metal is like a little Bluetooth light. So they're little lights, but they have little Bluetooth speakers. And, you know, get your guests to get your cell phone, connect to the Bluetooth, and have your playlist all ready. And you don't have to worry about hiring a DJ. And this worked out so great for this particular wedding. My next tip is to capture the meaningful moments. The moments like this one, when the husband-to-be made a promise to the daughter first. I thought that was such an amazing moment. The next one, you know, of course, is of the mom and the daughter getting ready for the wedding. I mean, all those moments is what makes your day special. And those are the things that you will definitely remember long after the wedding day is over. So you want to make sure that you capture those meaningful moments. My next tip is to surround yourself with the people you love. I cannot emphasize this tip enough. If I had any regrets from my wedding day, it would definitely have been my guest list. So by minimizing your guest list, you can definitely spend on the areas that mean the most to you. And just, you can do that by surrounding yourself with the people that you love and the people that you know are going to be in your corner. I know a lot of times when you create a guest list, you know, you're worried about offending, you know, your coworkers or, you know, some of your family members or family or friends of your parents and things of that nature. But if you create an intimate ceremony, you know, that will take care of all of that. And just explain to them, listen, you guys, we are know, really want to focus on buying a house after getting married, or we really don't want to invest a lot of money in this wedding. We want it to be beautiful, but you want to surround yourself with the people you love and with the people who really matter. And this significantly allows you to cut your budget and to save big. And then also, you know, people that you love will be able to create these kind of memories so that you can get amazing photographs for your wedding day. The people that you love will be able to do anything in order to make your day special. Enjoyed this video and found these tips helpful as you are planning your wedding in the months or weeks or days or years to come. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, it's Melanie with Living Luxuriously for Less. Cheers! Oh yes, and for a complete budget or breakdown of a $1,000 wedding, look down in the description box below and I will be sure to break it down there for you. And I will also include tons of DIYs for you as well if you're planning your own wedding as a DIY bride. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.